Hey you guys, I want to share with you my part 3 about my Bitcoin findings. So you might want to get a pen and paper. I'm not sure how much you'll need to write down, but just in case. FYI, these are only Bitcoin tokens, or at least got these from Amazon Prime. Once I have the Bitcoin logo, the other side, I'm not sure what the other side is exactly. It looks like to me the blockchain system. Not the ledger that keeps track of all the Bitcoin. Anyways, jotted down what I'm going to provide for you in the description box below this video, so please take a peek. I'm gonna make a link to part 1 Bitcoin, part 2 Bitcoin. There's a website, 99 Bitcoin. It's like a beginner's tutorial, kind of like a quickie outline. I'll post that link again, and a map of where all the Bitcoin ATMs are located. I'm here in Southern California. There are many, and when I found one, there was nearby my home. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited. I couldn't say straight. So I had been nervous to go by myself, because I kept imagining in my mind, like, oh my goodness, I'm going to be there, I'm going to have my money in my hand, I'm going to have my device with my Bitcoin wallet, and anybody who knows anything about Bitcoin, that's such an easy steal, because your wallet is in your device, and if you're standing there with your device ready and open to do a transaction, this is what I kept thinking in my mind. Anybody who has an inkling knows that if you steal that cell phone at that moment, you have that person's everything opened. You have their wallet with their money, the whole nine yards. And of course, I have a bad habit of building up these scenarios that are just terrible. But anyway, I finally got over that and went inside, and the ATM for the Bitcoins is right by the regular ATM, but it's huge. It reminds me of a European design. It's just huge. I can't imagine why it's so huge. It doesn't need to be so huge, other than do they need for it to be huge, tall? It was taller than me. It must have been, like, I'm thinking 6 feet tall. Whoever heard of an ATM 6 feet tall? A normal width, maybe a little bit wider than those ATMs you see in, like, little mini marts and stuff. Yeah. So, you have to enter your information primarily, which is your cell phone number, which is a little bit stressful because it's on a big screen, and I'm just nervous thinking, who's seeing my cell phone number in person or on the videotape of the store security? It's a little unsettling. But I got through it and followed all the instructions, made sure I had my $20 bill to feed once I got to the right point. So when you feed the money in, you have to hold up your device for the little address for them to clearly take a picture of your address, which is that square. It's that white square with the black design inside. I forget what you call it. You get it in focus in the viewfinder, and boom, it takes the picture and it says, okay, your transaction is processing. It should take up no within the hour. Your deposit will come up in your Bitcoin wallet. So I was so excited. And I said, this, oh my goodness, I did it. And people were looking at me. I think there were a couple elderly gentlemen. You know, so I think there's enough interest, but there's so many people that it's such a mystery too. But so, and then I kept asking the lady at the counter, like, where's the receipt? Where's the receipt? And nobody knew anything. But I think I knew that going in. I was going to be on my own. And one janitor guy came over and said, is everything okay? He didn't know how to do it. And silly me, I should have known. You only have two deposit options for your money. And you have to be careful in there. You might want to take notes on this. And your Bitcoin wallet, depending on the different Bitcoins you have. Remember, Bitcoin is like the whole name of all the cryptocurrency. Just like when we say, where's my money? We mean, where's my dollar bills, my quarters, dimes, nickels, pennies, 50s, 20s. When we say, where's my money? When we say, where's my Bitcoin? We're referring to all the cryptocurrency, which is Bitcoin, there's Litecoin, there's a couple of others I have on my wallet, I forgot the name, but anyway, so if you lose your wallet or you lose your address, your money is lost. There's no banking system. It's just you and the blockchain ledger. I'm not a financial professional. I'm just your everyday all-American Mary Hartman, Mary Hartman housewife. But so I was explaining to him that that's very, really cool, because if she put in, say she put in like $100 and she was going to purchase items with Bitcoin, say a month or so ago, I think it's gone from like the value went from $6,000 to $9,000 per share, I think. So suppose she put in $100 in her Bitcoin wallet, and it went up $3,000 in a month. So she goes to cash out her money. She says, I'm done with Bitcoin. So she wants to get her money back. So obviously she's going to get more back. I don't know how to do the math, because it's worth more. So for me, just at a quick glance, Friday, I believe it was around 9, and I'll list Market Watch. Market Watch is just a quickie. Market Watch. Stock market page. When you put in your stock symbol, really on the home page, you don't even have to put in a stock symbol. You just see, they show you the cryptocurrency market. So, seemed like to me on Friday, the value was $9,500 per share, and today, a couple of days later, it is $9,200. So, that $20 that I put in there on Friday, if I say, oh, I'm done with Bitcoin, I want my $20 back, I'm not going to get $20 back because the value dropped. But what my sister and brother-in-law are doing, they're they're just setting their money in their Bitcoin wallet in hopes that when they go to cash out a Bitcoin, they're not actually making Bitcoin purchases. Like, there's a ton of things you can purchase now through Bitcoin. Our TV cable company accepts Bitcoin payments. There's some donation places that accept Bitcoin Bitcoin payments. That's my next thing I'd like to do, is to make my first Bitcoin purchase, and I can share that with you. But so that's what that lady did. And when I was asking, where's my receipt? But see, you don't get a receipt because you have the option to either have your money put directly into your Bitcoin wallet or on paper. And it's a little spooky on paper, because if you lose that paper with the information on it, your money's gone. You can't call anybody and say, I need that money back. I need my receipt. I need my receipt. It doesn't work that way. Oh. I tried to explain to him that what she did, I said, see, it's just like if you go to a different country, it's like an exchange. And he understood a little bit. But by this point, like, I had no fear when I accomplished and did my little Bitcoin ATM deposit. I was so excited. And then I was triply excited when I got home and saw that it actually did go into my account, because for about 40 minutes it was pending. And then you see transaction complete, and it's in there. So I'm guessing, I haven't looked in my wallet today, but I'm guessing because I've lost money, as it's gone down a little bit, I won't have as much in my account. So I need to talk to my brother-in-law and kind of pick his brain, but it sounds like my sister did say they're not using Bitcoin for actual purchases. They're choosing to just make money off it, like their indirect way of being in the stock market, I guess. And then the other thing I noticed, I had to pay a fee for using the ATM, Bitcoin ATM. So my actual $20 bill, the deposit was like only $17, I think. So I have been forgetting to add that into the mix. But I much rather deposit my money into the ATM, Bitcoin ATM. It gets posted to your account so much quicker. When I first started putting money into my account, I had it come from my checking account, because they'll only allow you to deposit money from a checking account or a debit card. It took like 7 to 10 working days, weekdays. It took forever. Very unreasonable. So my deposits, hopefully in the future, will all be with through the ATM, Bitcoin ATM. What else? So, I would have enjoyed being there when that lady got her money out. It sounds like she got $200 or $300 more than what she put in. How cool is that? But again, she could have put in like hundreds of dollars to get that much. If I only put in a 20, Bitcoin would have to double. It'd have to go from 9,000 to 18,000 for me to get $40 back. So maybe she put in a lot of money. And people say, oh, I can't buy Bitcoin. You don't have to. You just put in whatever amount you have. And you don't have to buy like one whole share of Bitcoin, because that's really pricey. They give you a percentage. So I put $20 in, so I have like 0.111 part of a Bitcoin and the actual value, and then it has the actual dollar value. So when you go to make a purchase, you